שלום וברוכים הבאים לערוץ טוב. המיסיונרים אשכרה מסתובבים בינינו, זה קורה במספרים לא מבוטלים, מספר גדל והולך של יהודים, כן, גם ישראלים נופלים בשבי ונשבים בקסמו של, של המיסיון. הבאנו לכם סיפור מאוד מאוד ייחודי. With us today is Shannon. Hi Shannon, how are you?
Hi, thank you for having me.
Thank you for coming. You were born not only a Christian, but as you described to me earlier, you were born to become a missionary.
Yes.
How does this happen? I mean, what is the life course and what do you end up finding out?
Well, I was born to a family with, my father was an evangelical Christian minister. Mm-hmm. So in evangelical Christianity, the mission from a very young age is to spread the gospel to the world. Mm-hmm. And when I grew older, I focused that mission to Jewish people in particular, and was trained in techniques to bring Jewish people.
Techniques? I mean, you mentioned techniques, it sounds as if someone is working inside over there and thinking all the time how to manipulate listeners into a certain faith over the other. This the case? This is what you mean by techniques?
At the time, I didn't feel that way. Mm-hmm. I felt that I was presenting the gospel in a more culturally sensitive way, in a way that was more palatable to a Jew, that they mm-hmm. would accept, because the word Jesus Christ and crosses don't invoke any warm and friendly feelings within Jews. Mm-hmm. So if I changed the language and presented differently, they would be more accepting.
So obviously something happened. Your appearance discloses the fact that you are a convert and you had a giur and you're currently
yes.
a part of the Jewish faith. And first of all, welcome to our faith. What happened? What made you change your color in such an extreme way?
Well, that particular strain of evangelical Christianity that I was involved in used deceptive tactics in order to lure Jews, and part of that was infiltrating the Jewish community, and I did that. I would volunteer with the JCC, I would take classes at the JCC, I would deliver Meals on Wheels to the elderly. You'll mm-hmm. be surprised how open elderly people are to talking about anything, and it was easy to share.
Disguised as a Jew, or you present yourself as a friendly Christian?
I would not speak about it. Mm-hmm. It, you know, to get your foot in the door, you don't speak about it. You're not so open mm-hmm. about it. But you become a friend. And that was the big focus in my training, was mostly to get in and become a friend. Because when you're a friend, you're no longer a missionary. Mm-hmm. And most people will say they've never encountered a missionary. And that's probably not true, because most people will say, I have a friend who's mm-hmm. just happens to be a Christian. When they're a friend, they're no longer
so
a missionary.
If we have friends that are Christian, you say that chances are that they have been, well, trained in order to convert us.
Right.
So can you give us an insight into, I don't know, a particular story that Israelis may recall about something of this sort that happened over here?
Well, we had one of our biggest cases was the case of, it was a Rabbi Michael L. Cohen, who had infiltrated the Jewish community, a very Haredi looking man, mm-hmm. dress. He took on all kinds of leadership roles and titles in the Jewish community. He was performing a tremendous amount of Jewish rituals. Some of them have huge halachic ramifications. Mm-hmm. And he was all along a missionary. And the Jews that I befriended never felt like they were proselytized. And that was easy because I was a friend, and I was having normal conversations, normal interactions, and all along I was leading them to ask questions about my faith. And when somebody is asking you, their guard is down, and they no longer feel proselytized because they were the one to ask the question.
So it would start by them being asked by you about the Jewish faith, and you are to some extent expecting for them to return you or to repay you with a question about your faith, and this is the catch. This is when you open the textbook and start quoting things that you were taught in the church.
Right, in all different kinds of opportunities. Somebody's sick and you tell how you deal with a situation, and it's always intentionally leading them to the conversation of faith and inserting my own faith or conversations about Jesus along the way.
Okay. So, who are you now, Shannon? I mean, you mentioned earlier in the talk that we had before the camera was rolling that you are currently running some kind of organization. Please describe it. Please describe your current mission and the successes that you have in it.
Well, I went to great lengths to proselytize Jewish people, and in that, I was unfortunately very successful among unaffiliated, less religious Jews. My problem came about when I encountered more religious Jews. I was fascinated with the Orthodox world. I was inspired by how committed they were to rituals and traditions, but I had been taught that those rituals were empty and that they had no meaning because Jewish people didn't have forgiveness for sin because they didn't know Jesus, their Messiah. So they couldn't possibly have a relationship with God.
Let's dwell into it for a second. You said Jewish people in the eyes of the evangelical faith do not have forgiveness for sin as a concept, or the concept of tshuva that we do have in the eyes of the evangelical Christian is unapplicable. What is the version?
An evangelical Christian believes that without a sacrifice for sin, that you can't be forgiven. Mm-hmm. And Jesus, in the eyes of a Christian, was the ultimate sacrifice. And without accepting Jesus, you have no forgiveness for sin. Therefore, you can't have a relationship with God.
Therefore, our tshuva, that they do acknowledge it exists, is completely empty of any meaning, of any essence.
Right. It's not good enough. Yeah. You have to have shedding of blood to believe in Jesus. Yes.
Okay. So you took a deep view inside the Jewish community, the Orthodox Jewish community, and how exactly did it touch you? How did it endorse you to make the change that you did?
Well, as you can imagine, I didn't find a whole lot of open doors. Mm-hmm. I got a lot of pushback, a lot of confrontation, a lot of Orthodox Jews who would argue with me, and I found it very difficult. I had to find a new way to present it, and like I told you, the changing the language, I found a new way to present the gospel to Orthodox Jews, and that was getting them to look at Tanakh, because you're not going to get an Orthodox Jew to read the New Testament, but they will if I engage them and tell them that Jesus is actually in their Tanakh, and I'll prove it to them. And they would tell me things like it was mistranslated or that I was taking things out of context, which I thought was absurd. And I would argue back and say, you're just regurgitating what your rabbis told you. And if you just look at it, you'd see it. And in that challenge, I decided I was going to turn the tables on them. I was going to try to respond to them, and I was going to argue back. They said it was mistranslated. I'm going to learn the Hebrew of that verse. They said it was taken out of context. I'm going to learn the chapter, the whole book if I have to, so that I could present Jesus in context like they were asking. And in that learning process, it completely fell apart for me, because I found out, in fact, they were mistranslated.
Yeah, but it is still intriguing. So you were basically you found out that your entire belief system was based on lies. The information, the content that you were equipped with approaching Jews turned out to be false. So the natural thing to do would be to change course, but to stop doing what you do. But you took another leap and became Jew yourself. This is not a neutral decision. How did this come to be?
That revelation was absolutely devastating. It was an atomic bomb in my whole world. I had to myself go through each of the texts. There was supposedly 365 prophecies that were fulfilled by Jesus. And one by one, I had to go through them and understand why it wasn't true and learn the Jewish response and what Tanakh actually says and where those contradictions
happen. All by yourself, or were you instructed by someone, by some organization, when you were taking this revision into the Bible?
I was introduced to counter missionaries. One in particular was Rabbi Tovia Singer of Outreach Judaism. I started learning the Jewish response, and everything fell apart from there. And when I began to learn Tanakh without my Jesus filter, it was very inspiring. Mm-hmm. And all of those rituals and traditions that I thought was empty, I started to learn the meaning behind them and the significance, and they were all beautiful explanations. Mm-hmm. So I began to want to learn more about the mitzvot and to do more,
and how long
that landed me here.
How long ago were you standing in front of a Beit Din and was accepted to the Jewish faith? How long ago did this happen?
17 years ago, I began that transition. Mm-hmm. It's been, I think, 14, mm-hmm. 13 years
14, 13.
Since I stood in front of a Beit Din.
This is without a doubt a very interesting, amazing story, the change that you've been through. And ever since then, do you engage with missionaries? Do you do anything in order to resolve the problems that you've discovered with your own processes?
As you can imagine, I'm not very accepted in that community mm-hmm. anymore. Mm-hmm. I'm considered an apostate. My focus and what I founded B'nai Nu for was to protect the Jewish community. Mm-hmm. And I speak from a position of, I've been there, I've done that, and I know the tactics that are being used against you, and I want to tell you and share with you the tactics and mm-hmm. How they're doing that and mm-hmm. what you're up against to protect Jewish communities.
Okay. So thank you very much for your story. Thank you very much for sharing it with us. It is indeed enlightening. And אנחנו מזמין אתכם, צופים יקרים, קודם כל ללמוד עוד על הנושא החשוב הזה, ולהכיר בכך שהתופעה הזו קיימת כאן בינינו, ואנשים נורמליים, טבעיים לחלוטין, נמצאים בשני צידי המתרס, גם עוסקים במיסיון מטעם הדת הנוצרית, וגם נופלים ברשת של אותם מיסיונרים. אז זה התוכן שאנחנו הבאנו לכם בנושא החשוב הזה, ואנחנו נזמין אתכם להצטרף אלינו לתכנים נוספים, גם בערוץ היוטיוב, גם באתר האינטרנט ובעמוד הפייסבוק של ערוץ טוב. תודה רבה ועד הפעם הבאה. להתראות.